You want some soup? Come on. Hi. Get your broccoli soup for you. There you go.
Hey everybody, good Sunday morning to you. Well, it's the end of a long week. We had so much snow, as you guys saw in some of my videos. It was just nutty. So it all started off with that 10, 12 inch snowfall that we had, and it just kept on going. I mean, it's just been crazy out here, but it looks like we're gonna have one more for the end of it, and it'll be tonight. It's supposed to go into Sunday, let me see, they said start Sunday tonight around 9, 10 o'clock p.m. And then it's supposed to go till, I don't know, early morning, but I'll probably just get out there at 3 o'clock anyway and get started to get a jump on everything. What I'm out here doing now to wrap up Sunday, the chickens, they need, you know, they like to get around and walk around. So in particular, they have a spot that I have for them. It needs to be shoveled so they can get there because they won't walk around in this deep snow. They don't like it. So why don't you guys come over to the coop with me and we'll clear out a little path for them, and I'll show you what they do in the dirt. I don't know if I ever told you guys, but these two buckets, I've had these things around forever, right? Because what I do to get through the winter, you see all the snow and the, collects up there, and when it rains in the fall. Anyway, I store water inside for the chickens. I already have a 40-gallon tank that's I keep in there, and that gets low right around February. So during the rest of the winter, I put these two buckets out. And every few days I get, I don't know, between the two of them, probably 4 or 5 gallons worth of water. And I take it and I dump it inside there into their main water supply. That way I never run out of water for the birds. And I just run, you know, 5 gallons at a time back to their bucket down there. See where they're gathered up right now? That's where they go to drink. And it keeps them happy. So always keep some buckets like this around because you can always collect rainwater. Well, right here is the coop. You see it right there behind me. And they like to come out and run around and get over there. You see that little metal cage right there? Well, inside there, because you know, I have a roof on it, and same with the other one over here. They like to get over there because there's dirt and leaves. It's not all snow covered. So what I have to do is shovel from this little path here all the way down around in front of this fence. That way they can get over there. I hear them. Let's go see. Hi. All right, so here's some of them. They're just out now. They hear me. That big guy right there, that's Junior. He's about a, what, 3-year-old rooster, I believe? Yeah, something like that. But check them out. They know I'm out here. They, something's going on. I'm gonna have to check the eggs too, because I think they laid some eggs. And anyway, let's start making this path right here. You guys, I've got some leftover broccoli soup from during the week. And we didn't eat all the way, so it's going to them.
You guys want some soup? Come on. Hi, get your broccoli soup for you. There you go. All right, dig you guys pathway. See, when the dirt is this deep, or when the snow is this deep, they won't touch it. They just don't like the way it feels on their feet or something. But as long as there's a pathway, as soon as the sun hits this, it'll turn right to dirt. And they'll be right over here. All right. Come on, loons. That's a good path now. Oh, a lot better, a lot better. I'm gonna take you guys on a little tour of the path. Hey, I got the path out there for y'all. The other hens are already out there. Look at these two. See her? She lays a green egg. That's an Araucana. And a few other ones, they lay green eggs too. There's no eggs in there right now. There will be later. All right, you guys, we're gonna go give these people a tour of the pathway.
All right, so all they really have to do when they come out, I open the gate up, and they'll see this. Once this sun hits this week, that's gonna go to dirt quick. So they'll just come down here, and I'll show you why. They like getting into the chicken tractor because it never gets snow inside there. See that? Let me zoom you in a little bit. All right, it stays dirt the whole time. So they like to get in there and monkey around. It gets them out of the monotony of being inside the barn or the coop. And so, you know, they can come in the little door here. And then they go over to the banny hen house, which all the bannies are gone now because of the hawks. But anyway, they can go in there and mess around too. They can jump inside. Now, it's frozen. All right. Anyway, you guys remember when I built that? That's the chicken tractor I made a couple years ago. You guys remember that, right? I put a link for that up there too. So we'll probably do more meat birds again this year. So anyway, that'd give them a little more expansion room for the coming week. They were doing pretty good until we got this big snowfall. Then they kind of wanted to stay inside the coop. So, but they'll be running around here this week, I guarantee you. Nothing better than Sundays around the house. Take care of some chores. Little stuff. Make sure the birds are all healthy. But anyway, let's go into the barn or over to the workshop and show you what else I got going this week. Look here. You see that feather? That's not a good sign. That feather is on a tree right here next to the coop. And when I was digging the trench out over here, I saw some more feathers. That's probably a hawk trying to get in. Just like everything else, the deer and the hawks and everything else is hungry, so. And everything eats chickens, unfortunately. All right, let's go take a look what I got going in the workshop. All right, you guys, well, I'm excited to show you what I've got going this week. We have something I've been wanting to do, and this heavy snow kind of makes me, got me going to go ahead and make it. When we get snowfalls like these big heavy snowfalls, the animals have a hard place to get food from, so they're out there trying to scrape up anything they can. They end up getting into our shrubs, and I like to keep our deer, the ones that we always see all the time, I like to keep those guys fed. So what this is, it's a really simple, very inexpensive deer feeder system. I'm making two of them, and it's really cheap. I mean, I think under 40 bucks, maybe under 30 bucks, you'll be able to make these. Something really cool that I found, these tapes. See these duct tapes? This one, let's see, it's camouflage. And it's made, you know, it's a duct tape brand. Come on, get off my face now. So it's the duct tape brand. And it's the camel, the real tree camel. See that? Pretty good, huh? This one, also duct tape brand. And we have the Army Digital. See that? Separate from my face, it keeps focusing on me. But so yeah, we're gonna do two of them. And I'm gonna split them up and put them in different trees. If they work out good here, I'll probably take some up to our hunting area and drop some around the property. We're getting really close to maple syrup season, so I'm gonna get ready to get the maple syrup equipment out. My pan is over there on the other side by the firewood. And I know you guys have seen my other maple syrup videos. I'll put some right here somewhere. Go look at those. It's the same process. So what I'm trying to do is make it as efficient as possible. The last 2 years, not been efficient because I keep changing up the way I'm boiling the sap. And it all in the end works out good, but the setup is just, I need to finish what my thoughts are on this thing. Get them all together before we get into maple syrup season, which is gonna be 3-4 weeks from now, something like that. Just after spring break, probably, depending on what our temperatures look like. Got that. Got the two feeders for the deer. What else? I know there's something else. Oh yeah, seeds. I got a bunch of seeds. I picked up a bunch more seeds over the week. Last week or the week before? And I'll show you what I got. And I got my daughters a few things of seed, and they're excited about it. So I know I'm going to be going out tonight for another plowing. So I might take the little camera with me and see what happens, but after that it looks like a warm week, so I might not be plowing as much, which means I'm gonna have to go get the plow and take it and spray wash it. I got to get all the salt off there. It's been on there for
2 weeks now since I washed that plow down, and I just don't like all the salt sitting on there. It's not good for it. I'm sure we'll have another busy week. Stuff to do around the shop here and around the homestead. And I just want to keep you guys up on what I got going. So you guys have a good Sunday. Rest of the day, enjoy it. Don't work. It's Sunday. Relax. Stay with the family and do good things. So if you get a chance, you guys go and check out my website, jessejaymz.com. So go on over there and check that out. And if you're not a subscriber to the mailing list there, please do that, because I send out these week in reviews with the videos I made of that week for people who haven't seen them. So yeah, that's what we have going. So it's the end of the week, Sunday here. Gonna wind it down. I think we have some good chicken soup she's making in there, so that's gonna be good. About ready for the snow to get out of here. You know, I almost forgot. There's people who want to know more about Dutch ovens and cast iron stuff in particular. So I have a lot of that stuff that I cook with all the time. So maybe I'll get into some more of that. And if there's other stuff that you guys want me to get into or talk about or mess with around here, let me know. I'm always looking for good suggestions, good ideas of new things to make or film. I don't film at all because I don't think it'd be interesting to you guys. But every time it surprises me that somebody sees something in the background or whatever, and they'll ask, hey, what's that for? And can you, you know, talk about that? So there's plenty of that stuff. If you've come up with some ideas like that, let me know. Just put them in the comments or send me an email, whatever it is. I always answer the emails and I see all that stuff on my own. So hit me up. Let me know, okay? Love you long time. We'll see you.